G'day, welcome to Accelerate Maths. In this lesson, we will learn 13 angle rules. But first, let's look at the size of angles. In this clock, the two hands are pointing up. The angle between the hands is zero. If we keep one hand still and turn the other hand, the angle becomes 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 30 degrees, and so on. Now the size of this angle is 90 degrees. It's called a right angle. Now the two hands make a straight line that is 180 degrees. That's two right angles because 2 multiplied by 90 degrees is 180 degrees. If we keep turning one hand, the angle becomes 270 degrees. That's 3 right angles because 3 multiplied by 90 degrees is 270 degrees. When the hand returns to the top, its angle is 360 degrees or 4 right angles. Now let's learn the angle rules. Can you see that these angles in this X shape are the same size? These are called vertically opposite angles because they are opposite each other in a vertical direction. In this drone example, the vertically opposite angles are equal. An angle of 90 degrees in size is called a right angle. If we draw a line to divide that right angle into two angles, these angles together must add up to 90 degrees. These are called complementary angles. Here is an example of the corner of a rooftop. If one angle is 45 degrees, the other angle must be 45 degrees also because they must add up to 90 degrees. A straight line is 180 degrees. If we divide the straight line into two angles, these angles must add up to 180 degrees. These are called supplementary angles. In this bicycle frame, if one angle is 100 degrees, the other angle must be 80 degrees. In this shape, can you see that all the angles add up to 360 degrees? These are called angles at a point. In the starfish example, all 5 angles equal 360 degrees, so each angle must be 72 degrees. Here are 2 parallel lines. They're marked with arrows to show they are going in the same direction. When a third line crosses those 2 parallel lines, 3 shapes can be made: an F shape, a U shape, and a Z shape. We call these rules the fuzz rules. First, let's see the F shape. Do you see that these angles inside the F shape are the same? These are called corresponding angles. For example, in this fern, this angle is 40 degrees and its corresponding angle is also 40 degrees. Now look closely at the angles inside the U shape. One angle is obviously larger than 90 degrees, and it's larger in size than the other angle. These two angles add to 180 degrees. They're called co-interior angles. Co means together, interior means inside. So co-interior angles are together inside the U shape. In this example, this angle is 150 degrees, so the other angle inside the U shape must be 30 degrees. In this Z shape, the angles zigzag or alternate. They're called alternate angles, and they're the same size. See that these angles in the hashtag example are equal. The 3 angles of any triangle add to 180 degrees. Because the word sum means addition, we say that the angle sum of a triangle is 180 degrees. The angles of this bridge structure add up to 180 degrees. In this equilateral triangle, all 3 sides are the same length and all 3 angles are the same size. Remember that three angles of a triangle add to 180 degrees. So in this equilateral triangle on the satellite, each angle is 60 degrees. In this isosceles triangle, two sides are the same length. Can you see that the two base or bottom angles are also the same size? In this building, if one of the base angles is 80 degrees, the other base angle is also 80 degrees. The exterior angle of a triangle is the angle outside the triangle that is formed when one side of the triangle is lengthened. The exterior angle is equal to the sum of the two interior angles. Let's look at this example of a crane. The interior opposite angles inside the triangle are 70 degrees and 80 degrees. Because the angles inside the triangle must add up to 180 degrees, the third angle inside the triangle must be 30 degrees. Then because angles on a straight line add to 180 degrees, the exterior angle of this triangle must be 150 degrees. See that 70 plus 80 adds to 150? Let's see this rectangle. All four angles are right angles. That's 90 degrees each. So 4 multiplied by 90 is 360 degrees. All four angles of any quadrilateral, any four-sided shape, add to 360 degrees. For the last rule, here is a parallelogram. Remember that the arrows show the pairs of parallel lines going in the same direction. What do you notice about the angles opposite each other? Yes, they're equal. In this example, the two smaller opposite angles are both 70 degrees, and the two larger opposite angles are both 110 degrees.